So we will start our lecture. So today, who is going to introduce to us that what we studied last time? What was the main topic of discussion in our last lecture? Yes, Dish, bolo.
And yesterday we have seen the monoapic cross and the laws of segregation, law of dominance.
So we studied about their exceptions also. No? Did we study about the exception of law of dominance?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Do we have any exception for law of segregation?
No, ma'am.
So it is a universally accepted law of Mendel. Yesterday, basically, we studied about the two laws of Mendelism. And today we will move ahead with the next part, that is called dihybrid cross. Okay, it's a bit interesting one. But before we move for dihybrid cross, I want to give you a typical example of a sum. And this type of questions are generally very frequently asked in NEET examination. We will talk about that. I'm typing the question here. All of you, so that you can see this type of question very minutely observe. It is very easy for you to answer if you know the tricks. How many types of gametes can be produced by a diploid organism if it is heterozygous in one locus? If it is heterozygous at one locus. Okay, so this is the question. Now let me tell you, while I was teaching you homologous chromosomes and alleles, I told you that homologous chromosomes are pair of chromosomes. We obtain them from mother and father. They have similar structure. Apart from that, out of the two genes of alleles, they are present in the same position of homologous chromosome. That can be called as same locus of homologous chromosome. So, ye jo position hota hai homologous chromosome ka, we call it as a locus. Okay, so question kya hai, dhyan se socho. How many types of gametes can be produced? So they are not asking about the genotype for now. They are asking the types of gametes. Ye dekha gaya hai ki kai baar aap log gametes formation ke cases mein you get confused ki ek banenge, two banenge. I told you while teaching beta that it is always types of gametes asked, number of nahi. हो सकता है 100 गैमेट्स बने. वी आर नॉट राइटिंग 100 गैमेट्स, वी आर गोइंग टू राइट टाइप ऑफ गैमेट. अगर 100 गैमेट बन रहे हैं जिनकी जिनके अंदर कैपिटल टी है, तो हम उस ऑर्गेनिज्म के नीचे कैपिटल टी ही लिखेंगे, 100 टाइम कैपिटल टी नहीं लिखेंगे. सो यहाँ इस क्वेश्चन में हाईलाइट ये है हेटरोजाइगस फॉर वन लोकस. व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय दिस हेटरोजाइगस फॉर One locus. ये ऐसे questions को solve करने की एक बहुत simple formula रहता है. यहाँ पे type of gametes के लिए जो formula होता है, that is known as 2^n. 2^n. अब मैं आपको explain करूँगी क्यों 2qn. ठीक है, अब क्योंकि इन्होंने बोला है हेटरोजाइगस फॉर वन लोकस, दैट मींस वी आर टॉकिंग हियर अबाउट द मोनो हाइब्रिड क्रॉस. ये वन लोकस मतलब दिस इज वन लोकस ऑफ द क्रोमोसोम. ओके, वन मींस वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट वन लोकस मींस इसकी भी जो पोजीशन होगा इस क्रोमोसोम की, ये क्रोमोसोम की भी पोजीशन सेम टू सेम ही होने वाला है इन द काउंटर पार्ट ऑफ होमोलोगस क्रोमोसोम, तो ऑब्वियसली दोनों की लोकस सेम ही है दो अलग अलग क्रोमोसोम्स में, तो वन लोकस मतलब वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट पेयर ऑफ जीन, सो इट इज अ मोनो हाइब्रिड क्रॉस. सो टाइप्स ऑफ गैमेट में टू नंबर जो आता है, दिस टू डिनोट्स, यहाँ पे जो ये टू है, दिस विल डिनोट दैट जीन ऑलवेज एग्जिस्ट इन पेयर. As genes are always existing in pair, तो इसीलिए यहाँ two num का number आ रहा है. And what about this n? N is talking about the locus. N is telling you about the locus. अब आप ये बहुत आसानी से solve कर सकते हो types of gametes. यहाँ पे ऑब्वियसली टू तो टू ही रहेगा क्योंकि जीन्स वी कंसीडर दे आर इन पेयर्स, सो टू, एंड एन का वैल्यू हियर विल बी वन, सो टू टू द पावर वन टू. तो मतलब हेटेरोजाइगस फॉर वन लोकस, मतलब कंसीडर करो वो ऑर्गेनिज्म कैपिटल टी स्मॉल टी है, सो इसमें से गैमेट्स कितने टाइप के बन सकते हैं, टू टाइप्स के, वन इज कैपिटल टी एंड अदर इज स्मॉल टी. Understood this question, beta? All of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So, we will move ahead. If such kind of questions are asked to you in future, will you be able to answer? Do you want me to discuss another like example of like this? Consider karo isi mein heterozygous for two locus de rahe ho. If they are giving the question as heterozygous for one locus ke badle mein, they are giving two locus. Consider karo. So for two locus agar wo de rahe hai, they are twisting the question. One moment. Instead of one, they are giving two. So, उसके केस में क्या होगा? What will be the changes in formula? Pair of gene here, locus
will be
two. So, number of gametes will be, this will be two, this will be four. Now, let us imagine the situation here. It is equal to, consider karo two locus, matlab it will be a dihybrid cross. So, it will be capital T, small t, capital R, small r. So, what are the types of gametes possible here? Four types of gametes are possible. Always remember while making such type of gamete that in a specific gamete, capital T and small t cannot go together. This is one character. This is talking about character one. And this is talking about character two. Okay, understood? Yes, no? Now, obviously, out of these two like genes of an allele, only one will transmit to the next generation. So what will happen? Capital T can come with capital R. This will be one gamete. Capital T can come with small r. This will be one gamete. Small t can come with capital R. This will be one gamete. And small t can come with small r. This will be one gamete. Understood, beta? Everyone? So, अब आपको कुछ भी दे दे, even if they put the number as heterologous for five locus, at least for genotype you will need to think कि क्या बनेंगे, but if it is for five locus, simple formula you need to write 2 to the power 5. What will be the answer? 2 to the power 5, beta? Yes, Dish?
Ma'am, it will be 10.
2 multiplied by 2 is 4,
multiplied
by 2 is 8, multiplied by 2 is 16, and then
16, okay.
Then 32.
32. We are talking about the exponent power, hai na? सो 32 टाइप्स ऑफ गैमेट. अब टाइप्स के लिए आपको जितना भी सोचने पड़े, बट इफ यू वांट टू नो हाउ मेनी टाइप्स, यू कैन आंसर इट वेरी क्लियरली बाय यूजिंग दिस फॉर्मूला. इज इट क्लियर टू एवरीवन? This type of questions, very good. Okay, now we will look into. Yes, Dishi, you want to ask something, Peter?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, if instead of heterozygote, it is given as homozygous, so
if it is homozygous, then the type of gamete possibly is only one gamete. Consider, you asked a valid question. I will explain. Let me go to that page only. If it is homozygous, consider even if it is monohybrid cross we are referring, type of gamete will be formed one. Even if it is dihybrid cross, type of gamete will be produced only one. Even if it is trihybrid cross, type of gamete will produce will be only one only, no? In case of homozygous condition, there is no option of producing production of multiple gametes, but there can be twisted questions as considered that I was thinking of discussing after having dihybrid cross, that if genotype is like this, capital T, capital T, capital R, small r, and capital G, capital G, then in such kind of questions, here we are talking about how many genes? We are talking of two genes, but the type of it is like for one locus. So you need to see how to do it. That I am going to talk to you about after teaching you dihybrid cross. This type of possibility is there. If even if one gene is like heterozygous, in that case the number of gametes produced will be more. But if all of them are homozygous, even for one character, two character, three character, it will be always one type of gamete. Clear, Dish?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So let us have a look into what are the different other types of questions that you may find in examination. Okay. So consider, I yesterday discussed some of them, but now I want to discuss about some more questions which are mentioned in your study material also. If such kind of questions are asked that there is an organism called AABBCC. How many gametes are possible in this case? Sorry. Think and let me know. How can you apply that formula? Can you apply that formula over here? If you can, how can you find? Any idea, anyone? Chalo, let me explain this to you. It will be helpful for me. See, beta, here we are talking about a trihybrid cross, isn't it? Why trihybrid cross? Because this is our character number one. This is our character number two. And this is our character number three. Is it clear to everyone why we call it trihybrid cross? Class?
Yes, ma'am.
So, basically, but the strange thing is, it will be heterozygous for how many locus? Can you tell me? Consider हमारे पास क्रोमोसोम्स है, ये तीन जो पेयर ऑफ एलील्स है ये हमारे पास कंसीडर करो तीन अलग अलग क्रोमोसोम्स में ही अवेलेबल है, मे बी इन टू क्रोमोसोम्स में तीन जीन्स रह भी सकती है. कंसीडर करो कैपिटल बी यहाँ पे है तो उसकी काउंटर पार्ट यहाँ होगी, कैपिटल सी यहाँ पे है तो उसकी काउंटर पार्ट यहाँ पे होगी, कैपिटल ए यहाँ है तो उसका काउंटर पार्ट यहाँ होगा. सो ये जो हमारे पास थ्री पेयर ऑफ जीन है इसमें कितने लोकस के लिए हेटेरोजाइगस है? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट मी बताओ मुझे. इट इज हेटेरोजाइगस फॉर हाउ मेनी लोकस?
वन.
So it is heterozygous for one locus. Though it is a trihybrid cross, it will be heterozygous for one locus. तो अब हमारा formula तो simple है बेटा. क्या formula है types of gametes का? So we will write 2:9. It will be 2:1. And the number of gametes, types of gametes will be 2. Why? What will be the type? It will be A, B and C. And A, B and C. Understood everyone? तो देखो अब ये दो questions में फर्क क्या है? What is the difference between this question? यहाँ इन्होंने क्या किया है? तुमको कितने locus के लिए heterozygous है वो बोल दिया है. They didn't give you genotype of the organism, but you can predict the genotype. जैसे इसके केस में हमने simple लिया है, concept लिया है. हमने ये consider किया है कि ये one locus के लिए heterozygous होगा अगर, तो it is capital T small t. हो सकता है dihybrid cross भी one locus के लिए heterozygous हो. It is possible, quite possible. ठीक है. और ये क्वेश्चन में क्या किया गया है? व्हाट दे डिड इन दिस क्वेश्चन? एक्सक्यूज मी फॉर वन मिनट. हाँ एक्सक्यूज मी, आई थिंक सम नेटवर्क प्रॉब्लम इज देयर. सो व्हाट आई मीन टू से बेटा, कंसीडर करो इन फर्स्ट केस दे गिव यू हेटेरोजाइगस अबाउट हाउ मेनी लोकस एंड यू फाउंड आउट द जेनोटाइप. Here you can say beta, heterozygous for one locus can be having genotype capital T small t, even if this can be called as heterozygous for one locus. Because though it is dihybrid cross, heterozygosity is present in one locus only. ऐसे question पूछने का दूसरा कौन सा रास्ता आपके पास है? दूसरे रास्ते में what they are do you do? They give you the genotype. Understood? They give you what? They give you the genotype and then you need to find out that it is heterozygous for how many locus. Clear? Everyone? Is it clear to all of you? Class, am I audible to you? Please respond because I cannot understand if you
can. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So can we have a look into some of this kind of questions? I'm going to write it. You try and answer by yourself. Okay? I'm writing the genotypes. Can you write how many types of gametes you can produce in this case, each of them? Do it, and once you are done, raise your hand. Show me in the video your calculation. Okay, start doing it, beta. I hope the screen is visible and I'm audible to you.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, do it. Is it done? I saw Deesh is raising hand. Yes, Deesh, want to show it? I'm waiting for your video, beta. Thoda sa piche le lo so that I can look into it clearly. Like, let me switch off my video. Fir tumhara wala will enlarge and show. A, B, C, C. Didn't use the formula, Deesh? Niche dikh raha hai wo. First ke liye you didn't use any formula. So it is heterozygous for how many locus, Deesh?
5.
Nahin. How can it be heterozygous for 5 locus? That's what I want to ask you. Listen. Dekho. Dhyan se dekho. First wala question. Look into it carefully, beta. Is it heterozygous for 5 locus?
No, ma'am.
It is heterozygous for 0 locus. Hai na?
0 locus.
So 2 to the power 0 is?
0.
2 to the power 0, 0 hota hai, 1 hota hai?
1.
1.
1. So in this case, the formula will be like 2 to the power 0 and it will be 1 and the type of gamete form will be A, B, C, D, E. Understand? So the key is in identifying heterozygosity in locus. Okay, Dish, thank you. I want to see about others, what they are doing. Yes, Isha, you wish to share the second one? Beta, ruk jao, main mera video off karu so that I can see your video clearly. Yesha, can you speak something, beta?
Yes, ma'am.
Because when you speak, then only your video like get focused. I don't know why it's not coming. Yesha, can you like make it straight because you like kind of it's inverted in your case. Two to the power. What will be the formula for the second one? Yesha, can you speak the formula for the second one?
Ma'am, 2^1.
Why? Yes, 2^1. Why? Because it's heterozygous only for this one. For other, it is homozygous. 2^1, 2. So the gametes produced will be A, B, C, D, and second gamete that will be produced will be A, B, C, and D. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So who is going to share for question number 3, beta? Who is going to share about question number 3? Class? Am I audible? Yesha, once again, I want someone else to share this time. I asked one for Yesha and Deesh. I want someone else to speak this time. Come forward and talk. So class, I think some uninvited guest was there in the class. Okay. So after this, we will talk about the dihybrid cross. Before that, we discussed this part where we discussed that as per different types of genotype, how can we find out that it is heterozygous for how many locus, and we can find out the types of gamete possible in each case. So what do we mean by dihybrid cross? I think by now it is clear in your mind that dihybrid cross is a mixture of two words. One is di, which means obviously two, and hybrid means here we are talking about the hybridization of two characters. So obviously, as in monohybrid cross, other characters are also there. But we used to focus on only two characters. Similarly, here in this case, other characters are there, but we will focus on the transmission of only two characters. So Mendel performed such experiments with dihybrid cross. Let me get yourself accustomed with it. We can take any Mendelian characteristics. For example, let us take tall as one character. That is capital T, capital T, capital R, capital R. And here we are going to cross it with small t, small r. So this is pure tall with red flower. And this one is pure dwarf with white flower. Okay, so we will put a male female symbol. While you were showing me your answer, I observed that many people didn't put it. I request all of you to follow the procedure. It will help you to solve difficult questions. क्योंकि अभी तक आपको ऐसा क्वेश्चन नहीं आया जिसमें ये बताया गया है कि ये मेल है वो फीमेल है. They never mentioned the sex. That's why you are not understanding the importance. अगर वैसा क्वेश्चन आया, then you need to mention which one is male, which one is female. So obviously, by meiosis, when there is gamete formation, there will be only one type of gamete formation because it is not heterozygous for any loci. It will be small t small r. When they fuse by fertilization, there will be formation of capital T small t capital R small r. Once again, let me remind you, the letter we are choosing for dominant character, same letter, small letter, is chosen for recessive character. Agar capital T tallness ke liye hai, to dwarf ke liye small t होगा, d नहीं होगा. Second thing, हम जब characters को लिखेंगे, ये character one को एक साथ लिखेंगे और character two को उसके बाद लिखेंगे. And while writing, सबसे पहले अपना dominant आएगा, फिर आएगा recessive. Again there will be dominant, again there will be recessive. So this is the way we need to write. उल्टा पुल्टा हमें नहीं करना. So obviously, as you can see, its genotype is saying something else. So ये तो pure नहीं होगा. It will be hybrid tall with red flower. ठीक है. अब मजेदार बात देखो, अगर हम सेकेंड जेनरेशन में, दिस इज आवर F1 जेनरेशन. अब हम F1 की सेल्फिंग कराएंगे. सेल्फिंग मतलब सेल्फ फर्टिलाइजेशन. दैट इज व्हाट वी यूज्ड टू डू. वी ऑब्जर्व दैट मेंडल हैज डन सिमिलर प्रोटोकॉल फॉर मोनोहाइब्रिड आल्सो. and I will consider this as P2 generation. Again, let's take any random symptom symbol here. The sex is not mentioned. Now, who is going to tell me how many types it is? Heterozygous for how many locus? Bolo, chalo. Now you know the formula. So let me know. It is heterozygous for how many locus?
Four.
Four locus. How come?
And it will be two locus, 2^2.
Locus तो दो ही होंगे ना बेटा, four कैसे होगा? आपको मैं वापस से draw करके समझा रही हूँ बेटा. Locus मतलब position of that gene.
And locus दो होंगे, gametes four होंगे.
हाँ, वही मैं बोल रही हूँ. तो locus दो होंगे मतलब formula क्या होगा? 2^2. Isn't it four types of gametes? इसीलिए it will be capital T, small t, capital R. Oh sorry, क्या कर रही हूँ? One moment. Capital T, capital R, capital T, small r, small t, capital R, and small t, small r. Same will be here. यहाँ पे भी वही होंगे. Capital T, capital R, capital T, small r. Small t, capital R and small t, small r. हमें ध्यान क्या रखना है? That at a time in gamete, one of the allele can go, both cannot go. Remember the law of segregation. अब इसकी checkerboard बनानी है. I want all of you to prepare a checkerboard for this. Checkerboard बनेगा इसका और इसकी genotype, phenotype आपको मुझे बोलनी है. It will take time. Do not be impatient. करो. I will write down the characters. Let me write down the characters over here so that it will be helpful for you too. Do it by yourself. Don't try to find it out from somewhere. एक बार आपने successfully कर लिया मतलब आपका genetics पता चल गया. Now you will not have any difficulty anywhere. What happened? What is the status? Silence in the class.
Okay, ma'am.
So, if we calculate the genotype and phenotype, first we need to solve the checkerboard problem. Kindly check into your notebook that you have, if you have done it in this way or not. If I am wrong anywhere, correct me. Do not even ignore the sequence. So it will be capital T, capital R, small r, capital T, small r, capital T, small t, capital R, small r. So let me share the screen here. We were discussing about the capital T, small r, capital T. Small t, capital R, capital T, small r, this will be small t, capital R, small t, capital R, capital T, capital R, capital T, small r, small t, capital R, small t, small r. Okay, so who is going to tell me the phenotypic ratio? Yes, Yesha.
Ma'am, for tall, it's 12.
No, wrong. Let us write tall red. This will be tall red. Tall red. Okay, how many? This will be tall red. Now let me use another ink so that it will be easy for us to say tall white. This will be again, this will also be tall white. This will be tall white. So let me find out more tall red. This will be 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 something else. It is dwarf red. Dwarf red. So this is once again tall red. This is once again dwarf red. And the last one, the most unique one, which is occurring only once, that is dwarf white. Count and tell me the ratio. So four types of phenotypes possible. One is tall red. Second one is
I got the answer.
Tall white. Third one is dwarf red. Yes, Kausha.
9:3:3:1
तो कहाँ मिस्टेक हुआ था ऐशा?
मैम मैंने टोल्ड वर्ब रेड और व्हाइट का निकाला था.
हाँ तो यू नीड टू बी इफ पॉसिबल एट इनिशियल टाइम काउंट करो, काउंट करके इसको कट करो जरूरत पड़े ऐसे करके. समझ में आ रहा है? यू नीड टू बी वेरी केयरफुल. ये बिल्कुल डिफिकल्ट नहीं है, सभी कर सकते हैं, बट प्रॉब्लम ये है हम सिली मिस्टेक करते हैं. अंडरस्टूड बेटा? नाउ आई वॉन्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू वर्क ऑन जीनोटाइप. कितने वट विल बी द जीनोटाइपिक रेशियो दैट आई वॉन्ट यू पीपल टू फाइंड आउट. It will take some time, but I want you people to do it.
मैम मैंने निकाल लिया है पहले ही.
तो बोलो, tell me the types of genotype first.
Capital T, capital T, capital R.
अच्छा कितने लोगों ने genotype निकाल लिया है? Let me know first. Can you please raise your hand? कितने लोगों ने जीनोटाइप निकाल लिया है? आई थिंक वी शुड वेट फॉर सम मोर टाइम. आई नो कौशा एशा एंड दिस थोड़ा सा डिफिकल्ट पड़ेगा तुम्हारे लिए, बट वेट फॉर 2-3 मिनट्स बेटा एटलीस्ट, ताकि सभी निकाल ले फिर मैं बोलूं, नहीं तो उनको पता ही नहीं चलेगा वो कहां गड़बड़ कर. लेट देम ट्राई एटलीस्ट, वेट फॉर 2-3 मिनट्स जस्ट. Should we discuss now? सबका हो गया होगा? I think we can discuss. चलो this time कौशा, ईशा and दीश will speak. कौशा तुम start करो. क्या-क्या genotype है? I think if this part is okay for everyone, can we erase this part?
Yes, ma'am.
Because it will be difficult for me. Anyways, let's start from here. Let it be there. We can tally and check. So capital T, capital T, capital R, capital R. This is one type of genotype. Then capital T, small t, capital R, capital R. Capital T, small t, capital R, small r. capital T, small r, what are the other genotypes? Keep on speaking. Bolo.
Small t, small t, small r, small r.
Then?
Small t, capital R, small r.
Isn't it yes or no? Or other than that, there will be capital T, small r, small r. Isn't it? There will be capital T, capital R, small r. How many are there? तो अगर हम ये ले रहे हैं, इट इज हेटेरोजाइगस फॉर टू मेनी लोकस, तो व्हाट आर द टाइप्स ऑफ गैमेट पॉसिबल? 4 और 16 टाइप्स के ऑर्गेनिजम्स पॉसिबल, आउट ऑफ देम मेनी आर सिमिलर. तो इनकी नंबर्स बताते जाओ, वी विल बी एबल टू फाइंड आउट. बताओ चलो, कैपिटल टी कैपिटल आर स्मॉल आर कितने हैं? कैन वी लुक इन टू द चेकर बोर्ड एंड फाइंड इट आउट?
Mom, it's two.
So it is 2. Then capital T, smaller.
Two.
What about this one?
One.
Then waiting.
Two.
Capital T, small t, capital R, smaller.
Four.
This one.
One.
Then this one will be one. Then
two.
Then
one.
So what is the total? Total is 16. So this is how you can find out the genotypic ratio too. Understand everyone? Is it clear? So this is genotype, and this ratio we wrote is phenotype. Is dihybrid cross clear for everyone? Let me know. If you say yes, then only I will proceed for the law that Mendel formulated after dihybrid cross.
Yes, ma'am.
I want to hear from others because only 2-3 people participated in discussion. I want to hear from others also. Shyama, understood beta? Mahi, Kashish, Jia, Mishka.
Yes, ma'am.
Kar paoge na koi bhi aisa sub problems ho to? Chalo. So we will look into the law formulated by this thing that is called law of independent assortment. So we know, everyone know that the meaning of word independent means it is not dependent on anyone, but it's not related to anyone. It can do whatever it wish to do by its own. It's not at all relying on anyone. And the word assortment means arrangement. So what does it mean? How we can define the law of independent assortment? So it says that the genes for two characters, two or more characters, may coexist in a specific arrangement in parents, but at the time of gamete formation, they can arrange them in every possible arrangement. सुनने में थोड़ी अजीब लगता है, सो आई विल गिव यू एन एग्जाम्पल एंड मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड. यहाँ एक अलग चीज देखोगे बेटा आप, के पैरेंट में दो कैरेक्टर्स आर एसोसिएट. टॉल कैरेक्टर इज गोइंग विद द रेड कैरेक्टर ट्रेट एंड ड्वार्फ कैरेक्टर ट्रेट इज गोइंग विद द व्हाइट फ्लावर. ओके, बट जब ये गैमेट फॉर्म करता है और इन द नेक्स्ट जनरेशन जब ये सेग्रीगेट होते हैं कैरेक्टर्स, एट द टाइम ऑफ सेग्रीगेशन इन एफ लाइक आफ्टर पी टू जनरेशन जब ये एफ टू बनाता है, एट द टाइम टॉल कैरेक्टर कैन गो विथ रेड, टॉल कैरेक्टर कैन गो विथ व्हाइट. सिमिलरली ड्वार्फ कैन गो विथ रेड, ड्वार्फ कैन गो विथ व्हाइट. ऐसा नहीं है कि ड्वार्फ को व्हाइट ही चाहिए और टॉल को रेड ही चाहिए. अंडरस्टूड? दिस टाइप ऑफ अरेंजमेंट इज कॉल्ड इंडिपेंडेंट असॉर्टमेंट. क्यों? यहाँ पर टॉल कैरेक्टर अपने आप को इंडिपेंडेंट रख रहा है, इट इज नॉट डिपेंडेंट ऑन द रेड कैरेक्टर. वो रेड के साथ मर्जी हो तो जाएगा, वो रेड के साथ नहीं मर्जी होगा तो व्हाइट के साथ जाएगा. सेम इज विद ड्वार्फ. ड्वार्फ की मर्जी होगी तो वो व्हाइट के साथ था पहले, बट नाउ In F2 generation, it can go for next. दूसरी चीज मुझे जो एक बतानी है, you know when I was explaining you breeding experiment, मैंने आपको बताया था breeding करने से उसके next generation में हमेशा segregation proper नहीं मिलता है. It is always expected in F2 the characters get more segregated. आप देख सकते हो कि इसके फर्स्ट जेनरेशन में सेग्रीगेशन विल नॉट बी दैट मच, मेनी हाइब्रिड्स विल बी प्रोड्यूस्ड. जो वेरिएशन ऑफ कैरेक्टर्स आनी चाहिए दैट इज जनरली ऑब्जर्व इन द F2 जेनरेशन. ठीक है, सो दैट इज ऑल अबाउट मेंडल्स एक्सपेरिमेंट एंड हिज लॉ ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंट असॉर्टमेंट. ई लॉ ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंट असॉर्टमेंट इज अंडरस्टूड बाय एवरीवन? काइंडली कंफर्म. I want to hear from all of you. So, should I take silence as an agreement that you understood it and proceed? Or you want to discuss some part? Two people raised their hand. Deesh, any doubt, beta? Mishka, Nakshatra. Long time I didn't hear from Nakshatra. Nakshatra, you are understanding the concept, beta?
Yes, ma'am.
So that is all about dihybrid cross. Now I want to cast some light on a specific concept that. What do we mean this dominant gene, recessive gene, how they actually kind of work upon? So if we talk about dominant gene, basically what happens is beta, there is a terminology called wild type. What do we mean by this terminology? Aapke book mein bhi aap jab ye chapter padhoge, if you ask me personally, NCERT textbook में सबसे खराब तरीके से दिया है, कोई चीज point wise उन्होंने नहीं बताई है. Everything is given in the form of a story, which sometimes it's very difficult for students to understand. And many terminologies are used which is not defined there. So wild type means the original type. So what happens? कंसिडर करो कि इनिशियली डोमिनेंट ट्रेट ओनली कैपिटल टी दीज टू फॉर्म्स और रादर टू से सिमिलर फॉर्म्स ऑफ दिस कैरेक्टर वाज एग्जिस्टिंग इन नेचर. उसके बाद देयर यूज्ड टू बी अ म्यूटेशन. म्यूटेशन इज समथिंग विच इज इनहेरिटेबल चेंज, और ये म्यूटेशन के बहुत सारे रीजन हो सकते हैं. देयर मे बी केमिकल रीजन, देयर मे बी फिजिकल reasons, कुछ कुछ केमिकल्स होते हैं जो म्यूटेशन क्रिएट करते हैं. सम इन्वेशन ऑफ सम ऑर्गेनिजम्स लाइक वायरस इन आर बॉडी कैन बी द रीजन ऑफ म्यूटेशन, और इट मे बी During DNA replication, sometimes there are error that may be the reason of mutation. So, किसी भी वजह से ये change हो गया and there was formation of a new type of gene that is. तो generally nature क्या करता है, ये जो new type है which is not selectively having very good advantage, उसको वो recessive ही रखता है. Understood? And this is the wild type. तो अंदर ही अंदर होता क्या है जिसकी वजह से ये character recessive होती है, क्या गड़बड़ क्या है इसका? Let me explain that to you in a very simple concept. समझो हम skin color का option ले रहे हैं. I'm giving you a very simple concept. Skin color की example इतनी आसान नहीं होती है. अब समझो स्किन कलर के केस में ये जो कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स है, इट इज कंट्रोल्ड बाय एंजाइम 1, एंजाइम 2, एंजाइम 3. कैसे? एक पाथवे है जिसमें ए से बी बनता है, बी से सी बनता है एंड सी से फाइनली मेलानिन बनती है, जो मेलानिन हमारे स्किन की कलर को डिसाइड करता है. तो ये स्टेप एंजाइम 1 डिटरमाइन करता है, ये स्टेप एंजाइम 2 डिटरमाइन करता है और ये स्टेप एंजाइम 3 डिटरमाइन करता है. तो अब ये जो मेलानिन है, इट्स अ मेलानिन व्हिच इज अ केमिकल, जिसकी स्किन में जितनी ज्यादा प्रेजेंट रहती है उसका कॉम्प्लेक्शन इतना डार्क होता है. जनरली कभी आपने देखा है कि फॉरेन कंट्रीज में लोग गोरे होते हैं और हमारी कंट्री में लोगों की थोड़ी सांवला कलर होता है. इसका कारण क्या है? वी आर हैविंग मोर सनलाइट ओवर हियर. हमारे यहाँ पे साल में ज्यादातर टाइम गर्मी रहती है, वी आर मोर एक्सपोज टू हीट एंड सनलाइट. तो मेलानिन एक्ट एज अ अम्ब्रेला ऑफ स्किन, इट इज द नेचुरल अम्ब्रेला ऑफ द स्किन. दैट्स व्हाई आस टू प्रोटेक्ट आवर स्किन, टू गिव इट अ ब्रेटर प्रोटेक्शन, वी हैव मोर अमाउंट ऑफ मेलानिन. और हम दुखी हो जाते हैं कि यार मैं काली हूँ, कितनी गोरी है. देयर इज नथिंग लाइक दैट. It's all adjusted by God. Even black, dark complexions, people are more having better skin quality in terms of skin cancer. They are more protected from skin cancer caused by UV rays. So, यहाँ पे ये तीन enzymes decide करेंगे. अब समझो बेटा, अगर ये enzyme किसी वजह से बंद हो गया, तो क्या ये pathway आगे बढ़ेगा? Do you think this chemical pathway will move ahead अगर मैं उसकी शुरू की एंजाइम को बंद कर दूँ तो?
No ma'am.
It's not possible ना बेटा. तो ये consider करो, ये एंजाइम को कौन secrete करता है? Gene 1. Second enzyme is secreted by gene 2. Third enzyme is coded by, क्योंकि genes ही decide करते हैं enzyme कैसे बनेंगे. We will talk about it in next chapter. तो अब क्या हो रहा है? If any of these gene get mutated, अगर इनमें से कोई भी gene mutate हो रहा है, तो क्या होगा? वो वाली enzyme तब बन नहीं पाएगी. That enzyme will not be produced. इसके वजह से, ये स्टेप ना होने की वजह से एक वेरिएशन आएगा कैरेक्टर में. दैट वेरिएशन इज द रिसेसिव टाइप. सो ऑलवेज ये बोला जाता है कि हमेशा जो डोमिनेंट कैरेक्टर है, दैट इज द वर्ल्ड वाइल्ड टाइप, मतलब द ओरिजिनल कैरेक्टर, एंड ऑल रिसेसिव कैरेक्टर्स आर जनरली ओरिजिनेटेड एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ म्यूटेशन. क्लियर टू एवरीवन? Is this concept of dominance clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Chalo, I want to hear now questions from your side. I am not today teaching you further. Hum abhi question answers lenge. Itni interesting si concept humne padha hai. Aapko apni family related koi character ya kahin kisi cheezon ke baare mein koi question nahi hai? Anyone? Feel free to ask to me. Questions related to blood grouping, questions related to characterization, I want to hear from you. class? Waiting, no question?
There was a young...
Yes. Kausha, can you repeat once again?
Ma'am, 2 days before I saw a movie in which I saw a young boy having an old appearance. Like in his full body, he has wrinkles and all and literally looks like an old...
Progeria.
So I just want to ask...
The disease is named as progeria. Yes.
Okay. So it exists, right?
It exists.
Like this.
Actually, progeria is a genetic disorder and it is incurable disorder in which aging of a person is too fast. See, we all age. Okay. हमने देखा है सब लोगों की उम्र बढ़ती है. कुछ लोग ऐसे होते हैं जो 100-100 सालों तक बहुत तंदुरुस्त जीते हैं. कुछ लोगों को आप देखो तो पता ही नहीं चले 50 के एज में भी उसके फेस में रिंकल नहीं है. कुछ लोगों की 30 में ही रिंकल आना चालू हो जाता है. व्हाट डिसाइड्स द एजिंग प्रोसेस? डिसाइडेड बाय टू फैक्टर ऑब्वियसली आर लाइफस्टाइल, आर फूड हैबिट, द काइंड ऑफ स्ट्रेस आई एम टेकिंग ऑर नॉट. इट डिपेंड्स ऑन ऑल दीज फैक्टर्स. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट एक जो बहुत जरूरी चीज होती है दैट इज जेनेटिक्स. आप देखना कुछ कुछ लोगों की फैमिली ट्रेंड होती है. जब ये आजकल एक बहुत मतलब चीज आती है न्यूज में उठ के, इट्स अबाउट वन वेरी ओल्ड मॉडल कॉल्ड मिलिंद सोमन. आप ट्राई करके देखना, उसकी मम्मी है जो ट्रेकिंग करती है. शी इज अबव 80, शी इज फिट. वो एक्सरसाइज करती है, योगा करती है, पुशअप मारती है 80 की लेडी. एंड ही इज इक्वली एक्टिव. लाइफस्टाइल एज वेल एज जेनेटिक्स. सो कुछ लोगों की अंदर जेनेटिक डिफेक्ट रहने की वजह से उनकी बॉडी बहुत जल्दी एज करता है. दैट डिजीज इज कॉल्ड प्रोजेरिया. आप जानते हो देयर आर डिजीजेस कॉल्ड ब्रिटल बोन डिजीज. कैन यू इमेजिन? जिन लोगों को ये डिजीज होती है उनकी जो बोन्स होती है वो बहुत जल्दी और आसानी से टूट जाती है. मतलब आप और मेरे केस में आप थोड़ी सी गिर गए तो या पैर में मोच आया तो हड्डी तो नहीं टूटती है, मसल स्प्रेन हो जाता है. कई केसेस में हेयर लाइन फ्रैक्चर्स आता है. इनके केस में अगर आप इनको जोर से पीठ में मार भी दो ना तो भी इनके पीठ के हड्डियां टूट जाए. दैट इज व्हाट द सिचुएशन दे पोसेस. दैट इज ड्यू टू डिफिशियंसी इन कैल्शियम मेटाबोलिज्म. दे हैव दिस डिजीज बट इट्स अ जेनेटिक डिसऑर्डर, इट कैन नॉट बी क्योर. So why genetics is so important? Because by knowing the transmission of character, we can see how to modify it. If you don't have the background knowledge, we don't. Like I feel the tomorrow's era will be the era of genetic engineering. We can create vaccines. We ourselves can create virus, biological warfare. Socho na? It's so easy to have a biological warfare and so destructive it is. If I am going for a nuclear attack, that area will be destroyed, obviously. But whole area will be destroyed. Fir uske ghar, makan, uski cheeze, mujhe kuch nahi milega. But biological warfare, so asan. I need to only have antidote available. So these are bad part of biology. We should never ever think like that. But there are so many good parts. We can create new organisms which are like having better quality of the desired organisms. So that part is very interesting. I hope you are enjoying this part of teaching. Any more doubts, anyone? If not, then I will end the class. Think upon it. Try and see if you can find some more examples. Obviously, we are also going to solve some examples. But next day, we will start our lecture with the exceptions, other exception. What is the exception of law of independent assortment? What are the more other concepts of Mendel which he proposed are challenged later on that we are going to see in our next lecture. Should I end the class?